Hey everyone, the Salon Guy here. And today I'm actually going to be doing a little bit of hair, which is really cool. Something you don't really get to see me do too often, although I do it quite a bit in the salon. But I want to talk to you and actually do a live demonstration on a technique called balayage. Balayage is a highlighting technique that's been around for many, many years. It's a French technique, which means a sweep. So what you're doing is you're literally sweeping the color with a lightener onto the hair. I use this quite often in the salon. I think it's one of my favorite techniques. The results are very, very different than foil highlighting, I feel. It's something that's very natural. It grows out unbelievably well. Looks like the sun did it, and you can really do it in a short amount of time, which is awesome. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do a little demonstration for you guys on a mannequin, and I'm going to show you what tools I use for doing the balayage technique. So come with me. We're going to take a little journey into the balayage world. So right now, let's get ready for some tools. What exactly do I use when doing balayage techniques? Check it out. All right, so what I'm going to do is show you guys some of the tools that I use when doing balayage. So you need some clips, obviously. Any type of clip will do. The duckbill clips or any sort of clips, a tail comb if you prefer to use a tail comb. You can even use a chopstick, which I use because you're not really combing the hair that much because you're taking strand by strand. And you can actually use a chopstick to be a little more creative. This wooden paddle, which allows you to wipe the lightener or the color on it, and also strips of cotton. Like foils, what you can do is, you know, fold the foils and have them ready. We can take some strips of cotton because that's really what you're going to be using. And also, as far as the lightener goes, you can see this. I like to use a lightener that's pretty thick in consistency, if you get a good look at that. Okay, not too thick or runny, not too runny either, but you want to make sure that, you know, it's not dripping off from the brush because it's too wet. But you also want to make sure you can get through it pretty easily as well. If it is too moist or too wet, I notice it does have a tendency to maybe swell a little bit or somewhat expand onto the other hair. And it's also a little bit harder to work with because it likes to run all over the place. So you want to make sure it's a pretty thick consistency. All right. These are the tools that I use when doing balayage. So now what I'm going to do is going to set up the mannequin and we're going to get right to work. I'm going to show you guys some balayage techniques.
Alright, so I'm back and I have my mannequin all ready to go. And before I start doing that, I just wanted to point something out that if you're wearing all black, a really nice clues, you want to make sure that you wear some sort of apron. I happen to have on my Halloween themed apron, which I use around Halloween, which is kind of cool. So I would suggest putting on something just to make sure that you don't mess up your clothes. Alright? So what we're going to do now is we're going to actually go over the balayage technique, and I'm going to zoom in a little closer so you can see what we're going to be doing here in just a minute. All right, so here we have our mannequin here, and what I'm going to do is explain to you guys how to do a couple of pieces balayage. So the important thing about balayage technique is taking the actual piece itself, the first section. These aren't slices straight across like this. However, if you want to do that, you can. I really don't suggest doing that. That's not how I do it. What I do is I come in and take kind of a scooping, almost like a little scooping motion from underneath. So you're coming in at an angle, and that's going to be my first piece. Now, of course, you can choose whatever piece and however many pieces you want, just because you have the creative freedom to do that. So your piece could be this thick, it could be even thicker, it could be not as thick. So it really is up to you guys. So what I like to do is have my easel in my left hand like this, okay? I take my piece, my first piece, all right? So here we have the piece right here. You come in, again, left hand holding the piece. If you're left-handed, you want to use your right hand for applying the product, all right? Now with mannequin hair, it's a little bit different, okay, because it's not as thick. So I'm just going to take a little bit thicker of a piece here, with a little more support underneath, just so I can really demonstrate how this really looks. Okay, here's my piece coming in on top of the piece this way. You can basically go right down to the scalp. Okay, you're going to paint this piece all the way down, I'd say halfway through the hair shaft, and you're simply applying it just like you're holding the brush parallel to the hair shaft. Okay, you need a little more product. You like to go all the way down. At this point, you hold it up like this, and that's when you work in on the easel. Okay, the product will work its way through the ends really nicely. Then take a piece of cotton, lay it underneath, and drop down the piece right on top of that. And there's a balayage piece right there. Okay? Next section, come in again, scoop from underneath. Right? I'm just clipping this here because it's mannequin hair, so I can hold it down. There's my piece. Now again, you can go thicker, you can go thinner. All depends on you. But what I'm doing is, I'm taking some of the product here and I'm allowing myself freedom. So what I can do is I start a little bit lower, work my way right towards the scalp area, okay, not directly on the scalp, but close to it, all right? The closer you get to the scalp, obviously the longer it's going to last, okay? Work your way down. Make sure the product, like I said, is a pretty thick consistency so it doesn't run or swell or anything on any other hair. Again, hold it up in the air. Take the cotton, lay it right underneath, and there you have another balayage piece, okay? Now, again, you have complete control of how you want to space these out, okay? So again, it's really important is how you actually weave this piece. It's not a straight across slice, but it's coming from underneath, almost like on a curve like this, okay? So here's my piece again. I'm going to come in. So this is getting towards the front hairline, so we can go right in there and be pretty close to the scalp here, okay, which I like to do, and sometimes people like a little bit heavier and thicker in the front, so that's a good opportunity to do that, and this allows you to get right down on the scalp, okay? Again, apply it, and you can use this to hold the piece in the air. Here's your cotton, lay it right underneath, and then secure it in. And there's another piece. Then what I like to do, you can either leave it like this, or you can lay cotton on top of it if you're going to take another panel down. All right? That's pretty much it. I'd say to start off, what I would do if I were you guys, I would actually start off a little bit less. I'd say do it mainly right off the part. I wouldn't necessarily go and do a full head right away if you're not used to it. I would do a couple of pieces right throughout the perimeter, through the crown. As you can see, I have some on this side as well. And you can see it's lightening pretty nicely, okay? And as these pieces are laying here, you can take a look there. Just let it sit there and it will do its thing, okay? It'll lighten and it'll give you a great blonde on blonde look. It'll create subtle dimensional highlights, which I think looks beautiful. And so this is the Salon Guy laying down some actual hands-on hair for you guys with the balayage technique. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you for watching my video. Stay tuned for more.